Thank you.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate you being here tonight for our spring concert. We've had a wonderful semester with these brilliant students, and we wrap it up with our concert, and we're so glad you've been here, tonight. We opened the show with a balafon piece, which has kind of become a tradition, because we get to jam out a little bit to get warmed up. And these balafons come from Mali, West Africa. I had the good fortune to be there playing at a festival, and I saw these being played and asked about them because I had never seen any like these before. And I found out that they're very old-fashioned ones, and there was a guy that was making them, I think in Ivory Coast or somewhere. So I asked if I could get some, and they said, oh yeah, we can have them made for you. So I brought them back, and we've been using them ever since, and they're just wonderful instruments. They're diatonic, so pretty much any note you play sounds good. And of course, we're accompanied by all the students and Jonathan on the didgeridoo, which is an Australian wind instrument, very unique, that's played by the indigenous people there in Australia. And we had that one specially made, I think, in Bali.
Yeah.
You want to say something about it?
So that's actually, raise your hand if you've actually seen didgeridoo played in person before tonight, right? Well, this is a slide didgeridoo, so it actually, it's not the old school original one, which was actually a eucalyptus stalk that just fell over, and the old story goes is they were trying to blow the heads out so they could eat them, but nevertheless, they said, oh wow, this is making a cool sound, but nevertheless, this one is made of PVC pipe, but it's a slide didgeridoo, so you can actually change notes like a trombone, which I love because you can have infinite frequencies in between all the notes and whatnot. So, the next up, we're gonna feature Elise. We're gonna kind of take a seat and pass it over. She's in a Robert Elise and Theo Trio. We're gonna pass it over.
Just some context for this piece, it's a Mexican folk song called La Llorona. And La Llorona, if you don't know, has a really scary background story. So they made multiple versions of this. This is actually Natalia Rafales. She's a Mexican pop star who likes to do a lot of folk tunes. So this is her arrangement, and there's some really creepy things about it, but basically you just have to stay indoors when she comes around. That's like the premise.
Thank you.
That was wonderful, wonderful, Elise. We're sharing microphones tonight, so to hand off. But I want to introduce this next song. It's called Set Mala, and it's a Serbian folk song. It's in 7/8 meter, because there's any musicians out there who think about those kind of things. It's also featured on the Meadows World Music Ensemble album. We do have an album out, and so it's on Spotify, Apple Music, Amazon Prime, all that. So just look for Meadows World Music Ensemble, and you'll hear this song, as well as a bunch of other ones. But anyway, we hope you enjoy this. It's called Set Mala.
Ooh.
Thank you all. Thank you all very much. Well, some of you may have recognized that tune. It's called Miserloo, and it's kind of controversial as to where it originates. Some people say it comes from Turkey. Other people say it came from Greece. You know, there's a lot of competition between those two countries. So who knows? It's a very old tune, but it was made popular by Dick Dale. Anybody know who Dick Dale is? Oh, perhaps some of you do. He's a guy in the 60s. He came up with what he called surf guitar. And there was like a really fast guitar with a lot of reverb. And they used it on a movie called Pulp Fiction. And so everybody got exposed to this tune because that movie was very popular. And they used Dick Dale's version of it. He was a Lebanese guy, by the way, kind of like me. I'm also Lebanese. But anyway, that tune got very popular. But it's actually a very old tune, very traditional. And they don't do it the way he did it. He did it more like a really hot guitar kind of.
And then, as we know, the Black Eyed Peas, even the newer versions, would be the Puppets, which is not even that new anymore. I'm from the old. So, Black Eyed Peas, if you know that, it just grew from the 2000 era.
I'm more of an expert from the 60s, and he's more 90s and 2000s. So, the younger people know bands that I've never heard of. But they're all great. A lot of great music going on. Oh. Okay, this next tune is Zena. And this is a song by Muhammad Atawada. He's an Egyptian composer and kind of at the height of Egyptian popular music, which was during the 50s. There was a singer named Ensemble. Has anybody ever heard of her? Oh, maybe not. Okay. She was very popular, not just in Egypt, but all throughout the Mediterranean, Italy, Greece, Turkey. And her songs, whenever she had a concert on the radio, everybody would listen. You know, this was back in the 50s. And she would sing one song, it could go for like an hour. I mean, because she did a lot of improvisation. And they would use orchestras like the violins, because, you know, Arabic music has quarter tones, what they call quarter tones. So you can't really play it on a piano or a guitar, but violins can play anything, of course. You know, anything without a fret can play that music. So her composer, famous composer from Egypt named Muhammad Atawada, and he composed her music, most of her music. So this is one of his songs, and it's called Zena. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. you all so much.
Thank you all. Just checking the time. We wanted to keep this under 2 hours, of course. Okay, there's no intermission. But we're going to do one more tune for you. By the way, that tune was called Andalus, and it kind of reflected the time that the whole Iberian Peninsula for 850 years was under Islamic rule until 1492, when they kicked out the Jews and the Muslims and then became Spain and Portugal. But for 850 years, there were Christians, Muslims, and Jews living there, and it was a wonderful society. The Minister of Defense happened to be Jewish, and they brought Christians from all over and to share the art. And Andalusia was a pretty amazing time in history, some of the time in Andalusia. And so that tune is called Andalus, kind of with the roots coming out of that particular period. Anyway, we're going to shift gears quite a bit, because we're going to play an old English folk song called John Barleycorn Must Die. And this is going to be our last tune. It's kind of a medley. And I don't know if any of you remember, it became a rock and roll hit by a band called Traffic back in the 60s. But it's actually an old English folk song. And we're going to go from there into a couple of Irish reels. Called Julian Delaney and Drowsy Nanny. Drowsy Nanny is played a lot like bluegrass bands as well. And it became popular after the movie Titanic featured it in a scene where one, you know, the workers were downstairs under bombs just having a big party. And that's the tune they played for Drowsy Nanny. Anyway, this is our last few tunes. It's kind of a medley, and we hope you enjoy it.
There were three men living on the west.
Lauren, thank you to Jamal Hammer, the founder of this ensemble. Without Jamal, we would not be here today. Let's start over here with the fantastic violinist, fiddlist, however you want to call it, Joanna Selva-Leon. On flute, we have the fabulous Jacqueline Terry. Dropping it on the bass. Robert Kohler. We have a very special guest, Brandon Haslema on the percussion. I am Jonathan Jones, guys. Thank you so much for being here. Oh, well, not only our star, Elise Ramirez. Let's one more big round of applause for Elise. The audience for the bonus. That's the audience. I'm Jonathan Jones. Thank you guys so much for being here. Follow our Instagram or Facebook, whatever it is. Invite your friends, tell your families. We appreciate you here. And again, like Joel mentioned, take a listen to our album, Meadows World Music Ensemble. It's on YouTube, Amazon, it's on everywhere, Spotify, Apple Music. Thank you guys so much. One more time here for everybody. Thank you guys. Please stand up and come on. If you want to get a picture, we're all going to come to the front right now, because we always forget. Let's all go to the front right now. We're going to